There's much more with author Wally Lamb on our website as well. Look for the New Mexico in Focus link at the KNMU.org page. You can also find video on our blog. Now it's time to get back to the roundtable and more of the top stories of the week. Lawmakers, have their hands full dealing with the ongoing budget crunch, as we just spoke about, but it looks like there will be at least a few ethics reform issues on the table in the upcoming short session. First and foremost, a plan by Senator Tim Keller here in Albuquerque to revamp the way the State Investment Council, the SIC as it's known, Jim, is run. You've investigated a lot of this with your work with the New Mexico Watchdog and previously as well. Let's back up just a quick set. Let's talk about what SIC does, if you can, and what Mr. Keller and others are trying to get at.
Okay, SIC is the State Investment Council, mm-hmm. and they manage, used to be over $16 billion in funds from the State Permanent Tax Severance Fund, the Land Grant Fund, and various other funds.
It's money
that's put aside for when our natural resources are depleted. It's money that's used to run all sorts of programs. It's a very important project. It's something that doesn't get nearly enough attention, not only by the citizens, but the legislature as well. What Senator Keller has done, and I applaud him, is to say we've got to start paying more attention to what's going on here. The first thing he has proposed is a reiteration of a bill that was introduced by Senator Steve Neville from up in the Northwest to expand the number of people who sit on the State Investment Council. Right now, the governor basically controls everybody on that council.
He gets to appoint.
He appoints the State Investment Officer. He appoints all the members. He appoints basically everybody except the land commissioner and the state treasurer. And what I've observed is that they really can't keep a handle on $16 billion. I'm going to use the old numbers because I don't know what it is now. I think it's $11 billion or $13 billion, somewhere in there now. But they can't keep a handle on this. They meet, you know, once a month, and they come in, and basically you rely very, very heavily on the state investment officer. But what has happened is that Governor Richardson has directed some of the investments. There hasn't been enough accountability. There have been investments that have been made. One of the investment advisors pulled out because the governor was pressuring them to make investments that the advisor said made no economic sense. Mm-hmm. So he was using the State Investment Council to project his political power, which isn't what it's about. It was also being used to create jobs. It's not the Economic Development Department, but they were making really risky investments to create jobs. And in one of their programs, their small equity in program, the jobs were coming in at $400,000 a piece. Mm. I mean, we were given $7 million to one company that created seven jobs. The other thing under Governor Richardson that happened was there was a big push from above to get into riskier and riskier investments, things that have never been done before. And those investments have blown up. We're never going to see them again. Many of them are tied to the third-party placement fees. I think about $500 million tied to third-party placement fees that are simply gone. These are the risky subprime mortgage, you know, securitizations, the collateralized debt obligations, the famous Vanderbilt investment, which was $90 million, that never would have been done before. So the proposal from Tim Keller is to expand the number of people overseeing this so that governor can't pull all the strings. And the other second major one is to have people on there who have some expertise in the area.
That was interesting.
Right now, you get on there because you've been a supporter of the governor. Paul Blanchard, who runs racetracks, sits on the committee that does venture capital investments. Bruce Mallott, who's an accountant but not an investor, was the chairman of the governor's campaign finance committee. Chaired the ERB. These are necessary reforms that are overdue.
And Sophie, it was very interesting what Jim just mentioned about one would assume that if you've got a gig on the seat of this thing, you know about investing.
I think this really highlights the complexity, I think, for the legislators as well, whom we don't expect to be investment experts necessarily.
Sure.
It is a little shocking to think of how little investment experience was there. I suppose that one challenge would be making sure that you have folks on that committee who don't have a dog in the fight, who aren't personally involved. But I mean, what it sounds like is this is a group that was personally involved and they didn't have experience and personally involved, I should say, in the governor's campaigns. And so it seems very clear that we need to have more expertise on that commission.
You know, and Arthur, it's interesting. Part of Mr. Keller's idea is to, as Jim mentioned, the legislature will make the appointments now and not the governor. And it just seems just
shared.
But at minimum, a little more distance now. A little more distance.
And he would give the Attorney General more power to investigate what the three groups, I think Para is involved too, what the three groups would do. You know, all of this is praiseworthy, but you know what? It's insufficient. Let's face it, the corruption starts with the political process. The we talk about government corruption. It's really business corruption. Corruption starts with businesses giving money to candidates for office. And it starts with contribution lobbyists. If you've ever hung around Santa Fe during a session, it's a wonderful scene in which the lobbyists and the legislators drink amazingly.
Right. Barry Massey from the Associated Press looked to see what the contributions were to Governor Richardson from the investment advisors who got this business. I mean, and it was close to $1 million.
So this brings us back to what I'm sure you discussed a few weeks ago, a couple of months ago, actually, Think New Mexico.
Sure.
Remember, they came up with, they've been passing all kinds of common sense legislation through Santa Fe. Now they've come up with an idea, ban political contributions to state or local elected officials from contractors and lobbyists.
Sure. And let me slip Lonnie in here. You know, it's interesting, this idea that we kind of breeze past because there's so many issues here. The third party investment, folks. Yeah. You know, this is to the layman, it's like, wait a minute. We have this expertise in Santa Fe dealing with these people who are going to be in. Why do we need these third party brokers? It's just begging for a problem, huge problem.
I think of my own investment, and I deal directly with the person that I know is the expert. I don't need to deal with Jim over here to say, hey, Jim, can you go talk to my investor for me, my investor advisor, and come back and tell me what I should do? Mm-hmm. Why? Because I need to have that relationship. I need to understand what's going on. It's no different in this process. Whenever you involve a third party, you then start to build insulation. Mm. And once you start building insulation, you start to build more questions than you do answers. And I think what you continue to do by building these third party relationships is you're insulating someone from something. Once you determine what that something is, all of a sudden it starts to break down. But there's always a reason someone has that in there. And I think in my opinion, it's because they don't want to be attached to it directly.
Right.
Because they're not comfortable.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
You know, some,
right.
Of this is, some of this is closing the barn door, unfortunately. A lot of lasting, irremediable damage has been done to our permanent funds by some of the abuses. At the very least, maybe this will prevent that from occurring again.
Let's see what shakes out in January. Got to give Mr. Keller and others due credit here, because this is a big, big, big problem. It's Byzantine, it's confusing, it's bizarre. You know, constituents can easily turn away out of disgust or boredom, but he's going to stay with it. Now, you'll want to stick around for our on-the-clock segment this week. On tap, Rio Rancho voters will soon be able to vote wherever they want. A man is charged, Lonnie likes that, a man is charged without ever getting in his car with DUI, and our congressional delegation gives mixed reviews to the president's plan for Afghanistan. Also ahead this week, meet the new curator of the invertebrates at the Albuquerque Biopark and find out why the tarantula may be the victim of just bad PR.